What is Gucci, everybody? What is up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Dave Steals the Show. Today I'm going to be unboxing an absolute beast of a machine. It is the Alienware 15R3 with an NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1070 graphics card in it, paired with an i7-7820HK Kaby Lake processor with the Pascal architecture. I'm very excited about opening this laptop up. If you have been following my vlog and the drama that has unfolded with my laptops, you will know that I had the MacBook Pro, I got rid of it and got the Alienware 15R3. I got rid of that so that I could get the Dell XPS 15 because I thought lighter and thinner would be better. And then I started to have issues with the XPS 15. I sent one back. They sent me a replacement. I played with the replacement. There were issues with the replacement. And so I sent the replacement back and just got back another Alienware 15R3. But while all that drama was unfolding, the beauty is that Dell or Alienware added a GTX 1070 option, which wasn't available when I first ordered the laptop. So I actually ended up in this big circle of mine. I ended up with a more powerful laptop in the Alienware than I did the first time I bought it. So I'm really excited about unboxing it. I hope the drama is over and I have a laptop that works and is a beast and I can be done. Until next year at least, right? So, I'm good. Let's unbox it. Sorry, I got distracted. Let's go ahead and unbox it. Get this thing opened up. You got the Alienware logo here in the corner. It's like a paper bag covering of this box. So I'm just gonna tear this open. It's like Christmas. Let's get rid of that. This is the box right here. You can see it has, I don't know if you can kind of make out that it has it has an outline of the actual laptop that's inside. On the back, it's kind of a deconstructed Alienware laptop with the keyboard and the trackpad. I don't know if you can make out the detail. I'm hoping you can. 15 insignia on the side, and Alienware logo. Let's go ahead and open this puppy up. You guys be the first ones to see it. It's beautiful. I'll pop this puppy out. If you've watched any videos on Alienware 15R3, they're all pretty much the same. I like the little Alienware head. I think it's a perfect size for the laptop itself. You can see the hinge is set forward a little bit to allow for the vents that they added at the end over here on the bottom. In the box, I'm gonna put this aside for a second. In the box comes your booklets and everything else, and comes a little Alienware card with some social media invites. I don't know if you can see that there. And in the back here is where the big mambo jumbo brick is. This thing is massive. If you haven't seen one, it is very heavy and massive. So if you're going to be traveling with this thing and the laptop, be prepared to have a lot of heft that you're going to be carrying around. I've also had a problem trying to find a messenger bag to carry this laptop around in. So if you guys have any suggestions, I've seen the Vindicator messenger bag, but it almost looks plasticky. I'm trying to get like a canvas or something like canvas and leather casual. If you have any ideas or if any of you have one, please comment below and let me know, because I can't seem to find one anywhere that fits this laptop. They're just so big, I can't find one. So if you have any ideas, please let me know. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks, guys. All right, so put this aside, and if you're facing the laptop, on the right side is a USB 3.0 port and some vents. On the left side, if you're facing the laptop, is a Kensington lock, additional vents, a USB Type-C port, another USB 3.0 port. You have a mic in and a headset out. On the back of the laptop is an Ethernet or LAN port. You have a mini display port, an HDMI 1.4 port, another USB Type-C port, a graphics enhancer port, and the power cord port. Underneath, you have the grates for the vents that take in air, and the rest of the body is basically made of aluminum. Beautiful laptop. When you open it up, the deck of the laptop, this deck here, is made of carbon fiber, much like the XPS 15 is, except that the XPS has the like carbon fiber print, and this is just a smooth, soft rubber type feel. I absolutely love the feel of this. I loved the feel of the XPS 15 as well. The trackpad is very smooth and your finger glides across it nicely. And the keys of the mouse pad are clicky, but still with that soft rubber touch, which I love. The Alienware head powers up the laptop. I like the location of it. The matte screen, this screen is a 1080p screen with a 120 hertz refresh rate. They had the 60 hertz refresh rate, but I went with the 120. It's supposed to be better for gaming, even though I don't game, but I do edit a lot of video, and so some of my videos have action in it, and so it's good to have that 120 hertz refresh rate for it. It has the Tobii Windows Hello recognition, so when I open it up, the scanner will scan my face, recognize it, and wake up the laptop. It was excellent feature to the laptop. I love the Alienware insignia right there at the bottom of the screen. I think they did a good job with that, and I love the fact that you can change the colors of the alien head, the trackpad, the Alienware insignia, and the piping along the sides, which I'm going to show you as soon as I turn on the laptop, which I'm going to do for you right now. So let's see if there's some juice here. Nope. Oh yeah, there it goes. Look at that. Look at the piping along the side. It's blue. It's beautiful. On both sides. It's almost like you're in, everybody likens it to the movie Tron. You cannot program each individual letter to be a different color, which is something that MSI does. It comes in zones, and so you can program the different zones. And if you give me a minute to log into the laptop and do what I have to do, I'll kind of show you how that works. Okay, once you open up the laptop and you log into AlienFX, which is a folder on the laptop, it'll bring you to the command center. In the command center, you'll see that you can adjust the keypad, the trackpad, and then you can see the individual zones that you can change the color to. It comes with some programmable buttons on the side here. You can pick to program to do anything, really. And so if you go scroll over the color wheel, you can pick the color of your choice. So let's say I want the trackpad. I want the trackpad to be a darker blue. I can change it, and then you can see that my trackpad here automatically changed based on the color that I picked. And you can do any color, really, and it's pretty awesome. If you want the word Alienware to be a different color, you click on the Alienware up here in the programming, and then you can pick your color, and you can see it changed down here to whatever color you want. I can change it to whatever color I want. And so you can customize it. Then on the side is the piping.
You can see the piping down here and up here, and you can change that to be whatever color you want also. You just have to click on the appropriate piping side right here, and then I click this color, and why did it not change? Let me see. Sorry, there you go. Now, if I pick this color here, you should see the bottom changed, okay? And that's, there's four of them, so 10, 11, 9, 10, 11, and 12 up here. If you change the color, then it'll change the color of the piping on the sides of the laptop. And so that's a beautiful feature. The deck, I can't get, it is a fingerprint magnet. It will collect oils, so you will see it after a while, but it is so silky smooth. Soft rubber and it's carbon fiber. It's fantastic.
All right, so that's basically it for this unboxing video. I'm gonna put this laptop through its paces and I'll try to come back at you next week and tell you a little bit about it, my first impressions after having it for about a week. Until then, if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet, please hit subscribe below, and I will see you next week.